From the Rivers Casino in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. It's Poker Night in America, celebrity home game. Pittsburgh Penguins Night, featuring two-time Stanley Cup champion Kevin Stevens, the 18th most penalized player in NHL history, and radio host Matthew Barnaby, six-time Stanley Cup champion and Hall of Famer Brian Trottier, fan favorite, Cup champion and voice of the Penguins, Phil Bourque, Game 7 hero and two-time Cup champion Max Talbot, and your host, legendary Vegas comedian Vinny Favorino.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Poker Night in America, celebrity home game. We're at Rivers Casino here in Pittsburgh. I'm your host, Vinny Favorito. Tonight, it's Pittsburgh Penguins night. I am really excited about this. Let me explain. We're going to play a little poker. We're going to talk a little hockey. We're going to have a lot of fun. These guys have some great stories. We'll meet all the players in just a little bit, but we're playing 5-5 Texas Hold'em. And Amelia, shuffle up and deal. Let's get this game rolling. Guys, I am so excited. that you're here. I'm really excited you're here.
Thank you. It's good to be here, Vin.
You are a legend. You will never be a legend. But
we got about 13 Stanley Cups combined.
Yeah. When did you play with the team?
99 through 01.
I'm going to stay.
I'm in. I'll call.
All right, I'll call.
Call.
Check.
Those are big rings, boys. Compensating for something?
Good for bar fights.
That's
yeah.
True. That's true.
Check or bet? That's 10.
Right out of the gate, early position.
I'm out.
I'm on a 10.
Kevin Stevens, a little raise.
Oh, I can't do that. You let me that. That's good. That's good.
Raise to 20.
I was really unload on you guys.
You had good cards.
A little aggressive on the first hand there, boss.
Feeling
I know, Artie. Aggressive. Being not aggressive is not part of his.
apparently
aggressiveness helps.
Apparently, yes. That C that's on your jersey aggressive. Is getting to your head. And a like call it. Coming. There we go. Well, if you were looking for a flush. It showed up. We are allowed to talk about that, remember?
Yes.
That is 20.
20 right out.
In the game of hockey, a flush, you just kind of wedge the guy off the play.
Yeah, whatever you
more
want.
More and more, though.
You can say whatever you want to say.
I push more?
You can do whatever you want.
Well, that's good.
And now it's
all right,
about.
That's good.
You can say all in at some point.
I was going to say all in, but yeah. I was just going to push.
Did someone pee your court face this morning?
I just push it.
That's aggressive. The Audi I know.
Aggressive. Well,
just keep pushing, yeah. Borky.
Aggressive.
Well, I might land this.
Call.
Wow, instant call.
Yeah.
First hand right here. I mean, this is a TV show, like, and right away they're going at each other. I love hockey players. I love you guys.
Very nice guys, not too bright.
Right, exactly. But this is how you guys used to play in the planes and the buses, right? Really we're aggressive, go after each other.
What's that? Yeah, it's all friendly. Yeah. Friendly aggressive.
He's first.
No, it's
you. You're jumping out of your jersey.
I'll just put this in Borky here.
There you go.
Hundo?
Looks like a hundo to me.
Yeah.
And an insta-call. He called you, show you here.
I'm very happy I got out early.
Flush. He's got a flush. He's got the nut flush.
Wow. He's got
an ace over there?
Yeah. Hit the monster.
It was 100.
Wow.
I like it, Borky. I like it, kid.
I got nuts.
Full-time hockey right there.
Yeah. Flush is out of the gate.
Borky.
Unbelievable.
How do you not? There's not a paired board. How do you not raise him?
What a terrible beat.
My old
friendly, friendly, friendly forward.
Oh, my God. He wasn't being friendly at all.
The first hand.
Wow.
That's a nice. I've been sitting over there in about 5 minutes.
I'm not going to lie. My open-end is straight draw. Just got, wow. Yeah, it was
wow.
Not very good.
Wow. Pull those ace. Chips in. Way to start the game there.
Big hand.
Man. Woulda, coulda, and shoulda.
And you look puzzled.
Woulda, coulda, yes,
shoulda. That's a great hand.
King I flush him like a beast.
You did it.
Yeah. I'm actually surprised you guys didn't lose more.
I know. If I didn't know the rough,
you had
I would have pushed everything in.
I'm surprised you didn't lose more with that hand.
If I was like in the middle of it, I would have pushed it all in.
You know it's a two-hour session.
I'll be out of here in about 5 minutes. I'll see you guys tomorrow. God,
I don't think Mario's going to help you on this one.
Yeah, this shirt.
I'll raise 10.
Raise?
15
to go?
What do I have,
10?
Yep. Call.
Just, I'm just unloading everything.
Check.
Yeah, they raised already.
I can't.
I would have lost a lot more.
Oh, yeah. I would have been out of the game. I should have been out of the game.
I would have lost.
You wanted to go all in right out of the gate. Oh, you were calling it push-push, remember?
Push-push?
Yeah. Let me see, can I push?
Wouldn't you push all that in?
Not on 9-5, no.
This is a funny start.
There's other draws.
I know.
I'm just saying.
I probably would have.
I would have.
That's me.
Well, you guys have been hit in the head with pucks. It happens.
Oh, God.
20.
It is 20.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
20.
Artie's here to play. He's just messing around.
I know Wallflower. Holy cow.
I didn't come here to sit here all day. You know?
It's been two hands.
For a long time. He's here for a good time.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Two hands.
Artie, I like hanging with this guy.
Always a good time. He can't leave me early.
Now, there's possible straights out there.
I go 20 more.
That's 20.
You look so puzzled. Like, how can I lose
two?
That's 10. That's 20.
I'm puzzled. I am puzzled.
You have to live through the 2 hours, right?
Four cards straight on the board.
That does not sound healthy, by the way.
What is that?
That's how I laugh.
Go 40.
That is 40.
Getting a twitch.
This is great. This is so great.
Twitchy.
I gotta go.
Yeah. No. If this was a regular game, it would be one player to the hand, but hockey players, you need a couple.
Yeah, we double up.
You got no choice.
I'm going.
I'm not on that side of the table for you, Mac.
All right, let's not start swearing because you lose. Right. Let's not do that.
I would just call it.
He's just going to
lose. That's where I need. How many of these?
Eight of them.
They really think about it.
I call it.
Or 9.5 Canadian.
First to show.
Oh, you have to show.
I have to show him.
Oh, he bluffed.
And the four. Yeah.
Nice hand.
All right, I'm back
in listen.
It. I'm coming again.
Oh, no way. Not only are you back.
Some coaching going on over there.
I'm in the game, boys. I'm not sitting a hand.
Not only are you back in it, but since you won the hand.
Wait to get 54, bro.
Guys,
you can see the
corner. What's that,
smarter?
You got to look smart.
I'm trying to do an interview here. We're going to go, actually, to Kevin Stevens' interview, since you just took down a pot after getting your butt kicked in the first one.
What's the greatest interview you've ever had? Wait to hear this voice. Yeah, I played in 3 All-Star games, and 91-92 were the best years. We went back to back that year, and both years I had 50 goals, and I was first team All-Star, and we had great teams. I played alongside Mario, and it's an honor to play with Mario. You know, when you play with the top guys, really the only thing you really have to do when you come in and play in the NHL is come and play hard every night and score, be able to score goals. They give you the puck in position where they want you to score goals. It was great. You know, what else could I ask for? You know, I played with both Mario and I played with Gretzky in New York too, so I played with two of the best players I ever played, so I was lucky. You know, when my first memory playing poker is when I sit around when I was on the airplane with the 6 guys I played hockey with, and we used to race to get to the airplane to play cards. Borky's, he's an easy guy to read, but Max, I didn't play with Max. He's a little bit younger than me. I played with Trotz. It won't take long, sitting at that table 5 or 10 minutes to see what they're all about. I used to be pretty good. I'm a little rusty right now, but playing these guys, I'm playing. You don't have to be too good, I don't think.
Yeah, I would say rusty was the good word for the first hand. Yeah. Rusty was pretty good, yeah.
It's two good hands right off the top.
And you can't blame the frog for coming at you. You know what I mean? Second hand.
5 on you, too. Yeah.
Oh, that was great.
Perfect.
I'm so glad you recouped a little bit.
Yeah, got a little bit back, eh, Audie?
Oh, I didn't. Let me show my camera. I'm sorry.
Yeah, 3 guys from Boston.
Yes, this is great. Yeah. Phil Bork from Chelmsford, Mass. He's from Pembroke. But actually, are you born in
Pembroke? I met you one time. Remember in Kingston?
Yeah, we'll get to that in a minute. how Kevin and I met is very...
Oh, it's great.
It's
we
really
love each
an
other.
Interesting story. Yeah. Actually, I'll tell that story. So here's what happened. Kevin Stevens, I was a young comic coming up, and I was also friends with all the Boston Bruins when Cam Neely and Lyndon Byers were playing.
Name dropper.
So I go, no. So I go to do, you're the blind. I go to do this show, and I'm the headliner of the show, and the other comics previous to me are getting heckled ruthlessly by this group of guys, and they have a leader in this group, and it turned out I'm in the back going, is that Kevin Stevens from the Pittsburgh Penguins? And they go, yeah. I go, wow, he's kind of nasty, huh? So I get up on stage, and sure enough, he starts coming at me, and I said, you know what?
Please.
Yeah, why would I be funny right now? Why don't we talk a little bit? And it turns out that I knew that Cam Neely was seeing his girlfriend.
Oh, come on. You're crazy.
Well, I brought that up. No. And back when Cam and I were seeing his ex-girlfriend, because hockey players like to have teammates. Let's just say him and his group shut right down, and the rest of the show was quite enjoyable.
There's no way you were seeing the same person that he
met.
I was just watching, but I was seeing.
Yeah, you were seeing, all right.
And 25 years later, I go back to Boston to do a show from Vegas, and my buddies, who's, you know, also buddies with him, brought him to my show, and I brought up the stories, and he's like, that was 25 years ago. How could you remember that? And he says, he gave me $100. He said, please don't mention it again. I said, okay.
Vinny.
Yeah. Let's go at it, Brian. What the hell is that?
That's a ten of diamonds. You want the glasses again?
Oh, boy, Brian. Yeah, suit. What are you going to do?
Okay, in every pot.
That's
20?
That's 20.
I'll call you.
He likes the game.
20, we're going to be first to show.
Two pair?
Got two tens pairs. And eights.
Oh, I think he has a beat.
I got jacks.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, listen.
One thing I will say
about Kevin Stevens, though, we all know he was just a great hockey player. And let's see some of his highlights right now.
And it poked off a stick by Murphy. Mullen bounces it ahead to Ron Francis. He's joined by Stevens. Francis finds him. He shoots. He scores! At 8:10 of the first overtime, Kevin Stevens has won game two for the Pittsburgh Penguins, 7-6.
So at 4-4, overtime begins. Kevin Stevens shoots the puck in behind Van Beesbrook. He juggled it. They've scored. The Penguins have won it. What a remarkable turn of events. Van Beesbrook bobbled the puck and knocked it into his own net, and the Penguins win 5-4.
That's crazy. With no video review that they allowed that.
By the way, two things stick out to me. First of all, I could have scored that goal.
Great shot.
I could have scored that goal. Second of all, I hate all my coaches because I was never allowed in overtime.
You never scored a goal from that far out.
No, I never got out. I got out in overtime. I didn't get out when we were trying to protect the lead. I can say that. Brokey used to come on the ice to me, him and Bobby Erie, and say, hey, we're up one, get off.
Five. Wow. Yeah. But it's crazy how the ref was in good position to see that goal. They missed the hand pass in
2000. Oh, that was awful.
Yeah. They couldn't reveal it.
Terrible. Yeah. That's what. Oh, I'm out.
Were you guys glad when they brought, when they were able to review plays in the league?
I think it's the right thing to do.
It's the right thing to do.
You want to get the right call.
Yeah. So fast. The game is so fast now.
And we can even go to NFL, like New Orleans against LA this year. LA gets knocked out because of an egregious, that's a big word for you. I mean,
egregious, yes.
You know,
I agree with people all the time.
I'm so sorry. But an egregious call in that game. You want to get the right call. It's more concerning, even with the way the video was or the TV was, you probably can't even see if it went across, if there was review.
He was in the right position.
It's amazing how much knowledge, really. I love you as a player.
I haven't dropped out of a hand yet. What's going on?
But it's amazing how much knowledge you have in the game, but yet you didn't have the skills enough to be like on a box of cereal. You were on a box of cereal.
I was on a box of cereal.
Heinz Ward.
Yeah.
And half a box of cereal, and you didn't even get to eat that cereal, did you?
Cereal.
Yeah.
I love cereal. You should see the commercials that comes with that, though.
What was it called? Crunch? Is that what the cereal was called?
Crunch.
The commercial must have had like probably a $200 budget. It was awesome.
$200 budget? Yeah. So they didn't have milk for the cereal?
It was great acting.
I eat cereal. You look like you're going to the electric chair.
Oh, here we go.
You're like nonstop eating every day, just waiting for.
Wow.
It's okay.
You also put a lot of liquid in your body. Am I a vegan? Yeah. Absolutely. If I see a dandy,
is that a religion?
If I see a dandelion, I light up like a Christmas tree. I'm like, oh, a dandelion. Veggies. I will never be a vegan.
No?
No. I practiced it and it didn't work out.
Yeah. Lasted an hour.
My worst time of the year is Lent.
Len.
I gave up giving up. I just gave it up. I don't want nothing to do with it.
Check.
I will check.
You played hockey, Vinny?
Yeah, you know, you churn the things.
That's bubble hockey.
Did he play hockey?
I actually
no, he looks like an athlete.
I actually did play hockey when I was a youngster, you a little bit. Yeah.
You know what?
I'm talking to a guy who has a ring.
I've had two rings, but they cost me a lot more money.
Yeah, that's the truth, isn't it?
Yeah.
Check a bet.
Can I get those rings
for a whole five?
All right, I'm just because you're a legend, I'm going to call. Are these heavy for you?
Yeah.
I'm going to really call.
Oh. Manhole cover.
You know all right, I call.
Nathan's hot dog eating contest. That's a professional.
Quite
sport,
a bluff.
Wow.
What do you got? Aces?
Yeah, I have aces.
Listen. Make it funny. Make it funny.
He gets that senior discount. We are going to come back to all this fun and action in just a minute, and maybe we'll talk to Kevin about playing a little better. We're going to right now take a commercial break. You do one more I swear to God, you do one more fat joke, I'm gonna flick you in the I really am. I'm tired of
it. It was part of my game to be an antagonist, an agitator, a shift disturber, as we like to say, without swearing. Making junior, I was very small, and I had to go up against a lot of big guys. So for me to get under their skin and get inside their head was very important. I wanted to draw penalties every time I was out there, have our team have the advantage. So for me, it was about the mental side as much as berated them in front of their teammates. My favorite team to play for, Pittsburgh and Buffalo. Pittsburgh, I was at the Barnabees Brigade when I was in Pittsburgh, and Buffalo gave me my opportunity to start. I probably started playing poker when I was 10 years old with my mom and aunts and uncles along the way. So we were playing for 10 cents and 25 cents when I was very, very young. Moved on to that when I turned pro. It was a mainstay. We'd play in the hotels, and then I moved on from there and done a lot of events with the Daniel Negreanos, and went to Vegas. I'd go probably 5-6 times a year, sit in the poker rooms for 20 hours at a time. So I love it. Absolutely, I'm an agitator. I want people to get mad at me while they're there. That's when you strike. That's when you play a little bit further back. You wait for the right hand and know that they're coming after you.
When you do interviews, do you always look permanently surprised?
You mean brilliant?
Or are you wearing contacts?
Brilliant. Brilliant?
You know,
I have blue eyes. I apologize. And I want to thank my mom. Thank you for making me a degenerate gambler from the early age of 10.
10 years old.
Oh, yeah. Let's play poker.
It's all right. I went through it, too. But anyhow, you're very articulate, you know, well-spoken. And you pride yourself on that, but yet I saw an interview of you with, who was it you did the interview
Scott
with?
Scott Oak.
Scott Oak, you've done two.
Both with Scott.
But you're talking and you're saying, you know, that you love to get things going and stir things up. And you said, because people pay a lot of money to saw us play hockey. It's on YouTube, look for it. Saw us play hockey.
Yeah, I probably spoke to myself in third person as well that day, but yeah, saw us, I would say that's not the greatest English. Not as bad as
Max,
Bad May.
Max, who
he's like, oh my God, that's really good English.
Yeah, he makes everything, Max makes everything singular. He goes, I've been here 10 year. 10 year?
And I don't pronounce the H.
What? It's an S.
You're from Boston. We're going to see we hear your language right now. Yeah.
He's got a worse accent than me.
No, you got the,
but
you mumble.
Borky, you're from Massachusetts and you picked up a Canadian accent. How's that happen?
Because I'm a broadcaster now and nothing sounds worse than the Boston accent on the air.
So you figured I'll play a Canadian?
Definitely worse.
Yeah,
I'd rather.
Makes no sense.
Right? Hey.
Yeah, go Midwest.
Boston.
Go Midwest.
What's better than Boston?
I just saw a thing. It's like the second favorite accent.
Boston?
I saw that the other day. I don't know how.
You lose it quick if you're on it, but when you're in Boston, it's good.
You know what my favorite accent is on a woman? Is Philadelphia accent. No. Love that accent. I do.
What is it?
Yeah, mine is Swedish.
Yeah.
What's that?
Imagine Philadelphia.
It's the way they say cheesesteak. I don't know.
Philadelphia?
Of course it is. Of course it is. Not even going there.
A little weight joke?
Nope. Not even going there.
Did you run out of color for your hair?
Philadelphia.
That's not very
nice. Well, it's a little weight joke. You know I love you. You are my favorite non-cup winner.
I almost got to the finals once.
Raised to 15.
Brian, when you get a chance, could you let someone else talk?
I'm just laughing. You guys are so funny.
Do you notice why you're not invited to a lot of cookouts?
He's a cookout guy.
Come on. I'm
out. I first met Trotz. He was my coach in New York. My man.
Wow, your first coach.
It's great. Not my first coach.
Not coach. No,
first
was he?
Awesome.
Now you're awesome.
Yep. Yeah, we had good guys.
Now, out of all the guys at the table, all great careers, every one of you, but actually, Max, you're still playing hockey. Now, you were playing in Russia.
Yeah.
And now you're considering going where?
Maybe one more year.
Montreal?
Yeah, maybe, but I mean, I'm not publicly looking for a job, but yeah, I think the family deserves to stay home at one point, and if I were to play another year, give stability to the family, but I don't know yet. It's like 20% in the air. I still feel good. I'm still healthy. I still love the game. It's tough to kind of, you know, retire when you still kind of
just have it
and enjoying it. I
still have
love the room.
Is it also tough to play a hand while you're talking?
Yes, very tough to focus.
It's on you. Yeah.
Two things, one time.
Yeah.
What's that?
25, please. Whoop. Sorry.
That's
what do you think, Adi?
I think I gotta go just because I'm up too loud.
Have
of
you
mind.
Not played a hand?
You scared me.
Absolutely losing my. What time? How many is that? Is that five?
Math in the States is tough.
How many is that?
That's coach ever made.
Yep.
What is that? Six?
It's going on 25
clubs.
That is 25.
25 to call, possible flush cut there, possible wheel, straight.
He bluffed the first time and you won. You hit the river.
The table? Are you guys playing as a team?
I can't.
You're
kind of
like,
kind of
I can't. Burning brain cells right now.
So, last time he bluffed you, you called him, you hit the river.
Can you see?
But there's two overs with the ace and the eight. I would fold.
Yeah,
I don't think he's going to bluff you this time. Will you show it to him?
I fold.
I'll show it to you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you turn him over?
I think he's got the ace.
There you go.
My guess is he has the ace 10.
Ace 10. Pair of 10s.
All right,
listen. Now it's time to see some of
two
your
tens.
Highlights.
Can you imagine losing
so
that
this shouldn't take too
tens.
Long. We'll be right back.
How many times in this hockey game did the Islanders have scoring opportunities and didn't hit the net? Derek Plant sends Groshek in. He centers Barnaby, shoots. He scores! The Sabres come right back and take a 2-1 lead after some great Islander pressure in the Buffalo zone.
And they played a solid game in this one. Into net up there for Barnaby. You know the crowd would love to see him bag his third. Malakoff took it away from him. We're in the final minute of the play. Barnaby, empty net. Can you do it? Oh, yeah. Yeah, I can do it. Wow, Mom, what do you think of that? Three goals from your little boy. And the Sabres are going to take a two-game lead to Montreal.
Wow, great highlights.
Yeah, Barney definitely a guy that doesn't really get too many goals.
Yeah. got
a little celebration. You get hurt celebrating that.
It's called smoke and mirrors. make it appear like you get a lot more than you actually score.
Yeah,
so when they go back like, oh, my God, this guy was really good. Yeah.
I love the punching bag. That was good.
Yeah, thanks, Ty Domi.
You've definitely been practicing your selling.
Yeah.
On that.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't you? Well, when I played for Kevin Constantine in Pittsburgh, he didn't play me very often. So actually the one day, like literally he played me 3 minutes a night, which was the wrong call, by the way.
You should have had one.
I'm good. I literally would line four pucks up at the end of every practice, and I would just skate. I would jump over the boards, and I'd dump the puck in, and I'd skate right back to the boards and jump over. And I'd do it for like four or five checks.
Changing up.
And I would do it so four or five times in a row. And he comes over one day, he's like, what are you doing? I go, you only play me 30 seconds a night, so I'm practicing what I have to do in the game. I'm mastering my craft. He goes, you're an idiot. I go, and you're a bad coach.
Oh, no.
Wow.
He didn't last long. Thank God Austin Matthews didn't go to Switzerland and play for him. He'd never be a player. Check.
One thing about Matthew, he has no problem speaking his mind, right? Did you find that a lot in the league when you played with him? That sometimes do you think he talked too much and got you guys in too many scraps?
Who's that? Matthew.
Were you here for any part of the conversation?
Matthew who?
Barnaby?
Whoa. I was not playing with him.
We didn't play together.
Yeah.
Okay, then.
That's why I'm like, okay. Matthew.
Well, then you shouldn't have addressed the question.
I didn't believe
it. I played with Kevin.
I knew. Like, Barney could talk with the best of me. We were all pretty good talk, but he took the cake, and it was, you know. It was entertainment.
I said
you know,
some
it was
bad all,
you know,
things.
I never.
Entertainment's calculated. Like, I coached him, and, oh. and Barney used it to his advantage very, very well. The team loved him, team guy. Beyond that, like, pick your right moments. It was the right moment. So, hey, well.
Beyond that, very average player.
Underrated.
You're way too nice. That was way too nice.
Drops is so nice. So, beyond that, he was a great guy.
But most of the time, these are the best guys in the team. Like, meaning, like,
no question.
These are the guys you want to be around.
So
and that.
Respectful.
Everybody hates them around the league. But if your team likes you, you're going to have success. Like, Brad Marchand's the same example.
Oh, absolutely. When you're against him, you hate him. Yeah. But when he's your teammate, you love him.
For sure. Yeah, we got lots. Everyone in here?
That's why he's my favorite player. I mean, but Trotz, do you think you'll ever be able to take him to see the Hall of Fame?
No, but I tell you.
I don't think he'll ever be invited.
Matt, I'll take his son any day of the week and his whole family. Like, he's first class.
My
first
son,
class.
Just by the way, he has a full ride to Penn State to play hockey. Whoa. And called me yesterday. And told me he's not going to school.
Well, yes.
He's going to turn pro.
Wow.
So he's going to go to Finland. So, give up a
$300,000
education. Great job, kid.
I like the pro. So he's going to
Finland. He's going to Finland, yes. Yeah.
How old is he?
It's a dream. You can always go to school.
How old is he?
Check.
21.
21, wow.
21, yeah.
So I'm going to check.
Check, I guess.
What team?
Not sure yet. We were deciding now. Well, he's deciding with his agent. I'm going to check.
Check. But again. You and we talked about this. You and his mom talked it out, and she was a little upset about it in the beginning, but now she's on board. And you're not forcing him to make a decision for you, and you supported him, which I think is great, you know?
I think for anything, for your kids, you always want to just support them, whatever decision they make. We all make mistakes in life and whatever it may be, but you want to support someone. So he wants to be a pro, and at his age, he developed a lot later. He's 6'3", 170 pounds. He's very, very talented, and Brian's known him for a long time. He's a very talented player, but he needed time to develop. And at this stage, going to college is great. I think everyone should get an education and have something to fall back on. But if you truly want to be a pro, he's at the point now that he has to take that next step. So you support them. And I'd love him for to go to college, and Penn State's a great spot, great organization, great coaches, great place. I was like Rodney Dangerfield, by the way, when I went there. I was like, kid, you got to sign. This place is awesome.
Yeah.
It's time for us to take another break. We will be back in just a few minutes right here in Pittsburgh at Rivers Casino.
Well, as far as Stanley Cups, I've got 7 Stanley Cups total, 4 with New York Islanders, then moved on here to Pittsburgh in the early 90s. In the 91-92, we had back-to-back Stanley Cups here with the Penguins. And as assistant coach in Colorado in 2001, we won the Stanley Cup to Colorado Avalanche, so that's number 7. And I call them my creepy Oilers. We should add 8, but they snuck one away from us. Some wonderful things that have happened beyond that, which was the Hockey Hall of Fame. And to me, that's the highest honor you can achieve. My poker playing personal history is very novice. I know there's a thing called a full house, and I know there's like a straight, and I know there's all these things called a flush. Well, anytime we can, as a group, kind of all gang up on Phil Bourque for whatever reason. Phil's got that great attitude, that wonderful opportunity to zing you a little bit when he sneaks your money. So when 2 or 3 of us can gang up on Phil, for whatever reason, it's not because we dislike Phil, we love the guy to death, but it's an opportunity to get him back and then tease him for not just that night, but maybe for a day or two more. Well, I got 3 phone calls. The first one was from Kevin Stevens. He invited me and he said, we got this event here, the poker event. And then finally I got a call from Vinny. As you know, Vinny's got energy and he doesn't take no for an answer. And he was confirming, reconfirming, triple reconfirming, quadruple reconfirming on top of the confirming, and it was really fun to make sure that I was well wanted to come down. So thank you very much.
Welcome back to Pittsburgh Penguin Night on Poker Night in America, celebrity home game here at Rivers Casino in Pittsburgh. And let me explain why I was reconfirming and confirming. Because at your age, I figured you weren't remembering that we had an event today.
Listen,
I got to tell you, I'm the one in awe at this table as far as the talent that's here. But even the guys that are sitting with us, they all say when you walk in, he's a legend. And you are. I mean, four Stanley Cups in a row. You're the Tom Brady of hockey when you think about it. To have all those championships, but four in a row with the Islanders. Then you win two with the Pittsburgh Penguins, and then one as an assistant coach. Shouldn't you be talking more than any of these people? You have bragging rights.
No, it's fun being the quiet, calm, easygoing. And I enjoy the laughter, enjoy the stories. This is fun. This is a fun night for me where I get to be like in the locker room, the biggest laugh, right? I had the roar laugh.
Trust, can I ask a question?
Yes.
Because I've never won a Stanley Cup. You guys have. Is there one more important than the other or one that stands out more?
Well, the first one, I think, because it's the first one, it's that dream come true. I think that's special for all the right reasons. But to win the first one here in Pittsburgh and their first championship was extremely special. A 7-year gap from my last one in New York, and I came here specifically to win the Stanley Cup with Mario Lemieux. Then you win cups with Kevin and Phil and get to know Pittsburgh and understand the city and the joy of raising the family here. I mean, it's been a special place. So that first one is really fun in New York, and the first one here in Pittsburgh, pretty special ones. Yeah, absolutely. Thanks, Matty.
Oh, yeah, having Trotz and Pitt, man. That's solidified. He actually was a Madden Trotz playing our third line center role, playing with Yago in our first cup. That was the line. Boy, did you play with him?
I sat next to Yags.
But when you played,
every day,
Brian came in. It was like, you know.
How did we get him, by the way? It's unbelievable how we would get Brian Trotz in Pittsburgh. After four
free agent,
cups in the
free
island.
Agent. Free yeah, agent. Know. You know, yeah.
But the team was just that high caliber that this was just like the nail in the coffin to get him, correct?
So, Trotz, did you talk contract with the Islanders then, or you made a conscious decision to leave to go to a place where you thought you could win a cup?
I talked to four teams. I talked to Los Angeles, Gretzky. I talked to Toronto Maple Leafs. I want to be a Maple Leaf. I want to talk to Detroit with Steve Yzerman. And I talked to Craig Patrick here in Pittsburgh for Mario Lemieux.
Love Craig Patrick.
I wanted to go someplace where I thought I might be able to help somebody win a Stanley Cup. And that was the only reason I want to keep playing. And lo and behold, back-to-back Stanley Cups, you couldn't ask for a better ending to a career when you're like, not pushing the envelope as far as like injuries or anything like that. But I felt good, I felt strong, kind of like Max. You feel like you want to do it one more time. And as long as you got the energy and the opportunity and you're feeling good about yourself, man, chase it, yeah. Bobby Clark told me, play till your legs fall off, and I did. You know, the body couldn't go anymore, and all of a sudden you're like, no, when you can't stay healthy, you gotta turn it in. I was at the end, so coaching was the next best thing, playing, and boom, I just jumped into it, and Craig gave me an opportunity to be player coach, and I loved it. It was great.
Vinny did 3 push-ups once.
In a row?
Took a little break in between.
But how long were you playing before television came on board? And well, he's the only guy you YouTube and it comes out square instead of rectangle.
It's black and white. I love that.
They have to show the shot and the actual going in the net in 2 frames.
Oh, the kids like talking about the olden days. So do I.
I have the best hand, by the way. I can easily get out of this really quickly, and I can bust all you guys up really hard. I'm just telling you.
You're talking the talk, that's Barney, right?
No,
there.
I'm just telling you.
You're talking it again.
I like it. I can
get out early.
Somebody take him down.
I'm gonna check, but I can bust you guys up early. But I have a really good hand. I checked.
Check. Wow, after that speech?
Well, no, I'm saying I have a good hand.
I'm gonna bet $15.
I can bust you up hard if I get the hit.
Okay.
Scared me.
So that means you're on a draw? You need a board. You need a four to make you straight.
I don't even have
a board. You have to spell it out like that?
I can hit it.
Okay, he can hit it.
I can hit it. I haven't hit it yet.
Okay, well, that's honesty.
It's time.
I love the honesty.
For $15, I'm willing to take you down.
Yeah, okay. All right.
Oh, my God.
If you put your glasses on, you wouldn't make these ugly faces for America.
I don't want to look at you. Why would I want to look at you? I want to see you.
It's on you. I can still bust you up if I get it.
We can all check and be friendly. We can bet. We can do whatever you want to do.
I'll bet 25 because I don't think you want. I don't think you have much.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna call you because I don't believe your analogy. Analogy.
Analogy.
Arthur's an
analogy.
Sorry.
Is that a capital A or is that a small A?
I don't want to be in.
People in America knew how much fun we have when we're not doing these shows.
Ooh, look at all that. Whoa. Could be a moat.
Did you make your draw? Whoa.
I didn't make my draw.
Check or bet?
Check.
But I don't think you made yours either.
Oh, boy.
I could be wrong. I think I hurt myself, actually. But I'll go 25.
That's
25. I'll go 125.
Raise.
I hit your queen. I am a jerk. I am such a jerk.
You were that before the hand started.
Oh, your balls got you in trouble?
I'm such a jerk
before
that
the hand
I had
started.
The hand right from the start.
Two jacks.
No, I had the hand right from the start. I was the winner.
You slow played.
And I'm such a jerk because I let
Keep
you
Keep saying that. That's my favorite part.
I'm going to show you my hand. I'm not folding, but I'm going to show you my hand. I made my hand right away.
Mm. Wow.
Oh.
Wow. You made a big boo-boo.
I know you got to
throw that away and save your money.
Player.
Throw that away and save your money. You made a big boo-boo. You should have played that right out of the gate.
Yeah.
Now I've caught up with a queen to make a full house. And give you $100.
Yeah,
you can always play next time.
Marty, take a look.
It's only 100. I'll call.
Yeah, you're going to take a look.
You call?
My goodness.
That's why I talked you right into that call. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. I thought you had it.
Yeah, did you? Good call.
Didn't have anything to that queen.
Listen, while I'm stacking my chips, hold on, while I'm stacking my chips, let's see the legends highlights because I'm really looking forward to this.
Gillies is on the ice again with Trotsky in to take the face off against Gretzky and the Islanders control. Play comes to the line to Trotsky to Bossy. Bossy shooting it in back of the net. Andy Moe lost it. Gillies centered it. They score. Trottier walked right into it, and he didn't give Moog any chance.
And it's a two-on-one with Trottier. LaFontaine to Trottier. Just wide of the net. LaFontaine in front, off the side of the net. Here they come again. Trottier's banging away at it. He scores! There's number 500 for Brian Trottier.
Wow. Wow. I mean, I don't know what to say. I'm just happy to be sitting next to you. To play with a guy like this, really, Borky, how great was it?
You know what? People forget. Before Lemieux, before Gretzky, 1-9er right here. 19 was the man. He was the center. Yeah. You didn't give me any chips for that either. But
2-9er, 1-9er.
You were the guy, man. You were boss. It was the boss show. You and boss.
It was fun playing with great players. And obviously, you know, when you play with great teams, good things happen. I was fortunate. It's one of those things, the right time, right my style of game. I thought it was the friendliest guy on the ice, right? So until somebody hit me and all of a sudden, uh-oh. And then it was a different kind of game, but it was really kind of a fun time. Lucked out.
When you came into the league, though, you weren't wearing helmets and stuff like that, correct? I mean, it was real high. It was tough.
I was elbow height, so I made sure I had a helmet on. Like anybody who was 6 foot, they'd hit me and their elbow would be hitting me right in the ear, and I hated that. So I always made sure I had my helmet on, but it was really kind of one of those things. I said, I'm going to make sure I have a helmet because I played an aggressive game and I liked it, and competition is competition, and the odd strange stick comes up. I didn't want to take a whack in the head. And helmets were there.
But you're so humble. You're talking about your teammates, like, you know, you were the guy that was making the team great. You know, you're talking about, you know, when...
So I love this guy, man.
No, but you got to Pittsburgh, and everybody, I'm sure, gained so much confidence
from
having a guy like you in the team. You know, it's priceless. Having a leader like this, and you join Mario just to win a cup, and you win two in a row, it's
25.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah, it's good fortune, but I think when you come in with the right attitude, the right thought process, good things happen. And I believe that Pittsburgh had
a good group.
Check.
You already called him. Do you have a heart?
I got something.
You know, stuck.
Four hearts. Well, we are going to take another break. We will be back to all these great stories. It's just an amazing night. We'll see you in a minute.
I love the storytelling. Thank you.
Queen, I should punch you in the face right now. I hate you, Vinny. I hope you get diarrhea tonight.
How would you like to play against the pros on national TV? Download now to play and win. It's absolutely free to play.
Welcome back to Pittsburgh Penguins Night, right here on Poker Night in America, the celebrity home game here at Rivers Casino in beautiful Pittsburgh. We're having a great time. You guys are actually being too nice with your stories. I thought you'd be all over each other.
You told us to be nice.
I know you're a little upset with me because I caught up to you in the hand that you played so poorly.
You're a bad player that got a great beat at the end. Like, there's no way of getting you off that hand. I actually didn't lose as much as I thought. And I paid you off only because I feel bad for you. But try it again.
Try it again.
Yeah, try it.
Oh, sorry.
Terrible.
Yeah, no load in this.
So bad.
Yeah.
So bad. What was worse, that hand, the way you played it, or me pulling my pants down last night at Hyde Steakhouse?
You know what? Seriously, we go out. It gets to be a little much with him. And listen, I'm all about the pranks, and I did get him this afternoon. How's the salt?
Yeah.
But anyhow, we're at this beautiful steakhouse last night, and because they heard Trotz was coming, they sent us a complimentary lobster tail. But right in the middle of the steakhouse, for no apparent reason, he just stands up, turns around, and drops his drawers. And Kevin called.
No, but I have my underwear on.
I went to Uber quick. I went to Uber before the pants got up.
Yeah, he called his Uber and says, "Get me out of here. My buddy's pulling his pants down."
I have no idea why he pulled them.
Why would you do that? And you did it the night before too. What is going on with you? Are you just a deviant? I don't get it. Why do you?
I thought it was Sharknado.
Do you think the women will flock to you because you're dropping your drawers? I don't get why you do it.
I have a girlfriend, so no, it was for your entertainment value only.
Hey, Vinny, thanks for the phone call, by the way. Huh?
Me
and the invite.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Absolutely.
Because I was not there.
No, it's true.
Thank God.
Yeah, seriously.
Dinner was great.
Let me tell you, dinner was unbelievable. Todd Anderson took us all out to dinner, and it was unbelievable, fabulous. They kept telling me about the steakhouse, and I gotta tell you, it was really good.
You had a 32-ounce steak, by the way.
No, 22 ounces.
I ordered an 8-ounce steak here, 32 ounces.
It was 22 ounces, and it was really 19 because the bone is 2 ounces.
Oh, yes.
Correct?
You ate 20, you're right. It was delicious.
2 clubs, 2 spades.
And you had 22 vodka sodas.
Did you have clubs?
You had?
No, I had a couple martinis.
How can you possibly drink that much? It's crazy. I don't know how you walk.
And feel fine.
Can't do it, Brian. Hate to say it, I can't do it.
No?
No. I love to, but I just can't keep throwing my money away.
Lots of queens.
Queens?
Hey, there you go. Another one.
Queens again. I hate queens now.
You know what? Listen, you guys, I am not an athlete. That's pretty obvious. But I am a stand-up comedian. You can catch me, Vinny Favorito, in Vinny's Room at Nick's Comedy Stop in Boston on 100 Warrington Street. Every Friday and Saturday, starting at the end of June.
I'm coming.
My opening act, Joey Carroll. We have a great time. You want to see a funny show? You're in Boston. Please come by and see me.
He's awesome.
I saw him last year, and could have been funny. I haven't seen him in 25 years. Felt like I've seen him the week before.
You know? That was great, man. Yeah, I was so glad you came that night too. Awesome. We had a great show. A lot of celebrities showed up that night.
Awesome.
Our actor buddies, friends we grew up with. I mean, it was really an amazing night. I ended up doing a 2-hour show at this comedy club. And afterwards, but just to see him and all the guys, because I was living in Vegas so long, and that was the decision maker for me to go home, to move back to Boston.
It was awesome.
There's nothing better than Boston crowds. I don't care if it's sports or it's comedy or anything.
Yeah,
I mean, that's
keep you honest, don't they?
Exactly, they do. It's the truth. It's the truth. You played in the Garden when people would clap, paint chips would fall from the ceiling. That's how great the original Boston Garden was. And now it's the the big fancy, what was it, Fleet Center, then TD Garden. And
it's
all
TD
that
Garden now.
I know,
right?
But why do they change names so many times?
Money.
Money. Yeah,
they pay a lot of money to actually get the naming rights. It's amazing how that works, right?
But funny is my thing, but you know what? It's like you. You have got a side of you that's so funny. Your podcast, you do your serious radio show, but you make it enjoyable to listen to. You know what I mean? You're funny. You're not like one of these boring commentators on television like Rob Ray.
He has vertigo, by the way.
He does have vertigo. Yeah, he's supposed to be on the show. We hope he's okay. We love Rob Ray.
Yeah, Matt Burnaby Unfiltered. I love it. I love being real, and that's what these guys are. And I could never work for a team. It's just hard for me, only because I can't toe the company line in the fact that I need to be honest.
Right.
I like to be funny. But I'm very, very opinionated. It gets me in trouble sometimes.
Can I make more money in the game?
I'm okay.
Hockey is lacking guys like that in general. I think we're so
we have to wait till the hand's over.
Traditional. There's a lot of guys that's like, we don't want to cause trouble. We're polite. So when you see guys getting out of the box like other sports, you're like, okay, this guy is funny, special. You look at a guy like Paul Bissonnette, you know, like
he's
doing well for himself. It's amazing. Okay. He was here. He was a Pittsburgh Penguin, actually, and crap, he was a.
Now you yourself, Max, you're from Montreal originally.
Yeah.
And how long had you been in the States?
Well, I was 11 years in the States. Yeah.
11 years. Is there any chance of losing that accent at all? I mean, how long does it take for you to catch on?
No, never.
It's kind of annoying.
God, thank you. Thank
the whole French thing. I know it's a great way to pick up women. Oh, let me get that for you. To us, it's like a Pink Panther movie. It's just, a little much.
You don't like it?
Yeah.
I love it.
I
really do. I think it's sexy. Really sexy.
What's he got?
He's got a straight.
Lots of
looks space. Like you're rebuying, and it looks like we are also going to spend some money on commercials. We'll be back in just a couple of minutes right here on Poker Night in America Celebrity Home Game.
He goes, I can't even see that car.
Stop swearing.
How would you like to play against the pros on national TV? Download now to play and win. It's absolutely free to play.
Hey guys, welcome back. We're about halfway through. Let's go ahead and check in on those chip counts. This table is getting borked. Phil up 605, our host up 250. Trottier, who doesn't really play, he's even, that's pretty good. Max Talbot stuck 95, Matthew Barnaby in the hole 260, and Kevin Stevens, woof, he's down a full buy-in. But there's still plenty of time left in this session, so let's go ahead and get back to the action.
Thanks for the chip count update, Jesse. Welcome.
I got this. Welcome back to Poker Night in America. I'm your host, Matthew Barnaby. These are my four friends, and this guy who had queens at one point. Welcome back. Enjoy.
What happened to Celebrity Home Game? It's a different
celebrity
show.
Celebrity Home Game. I apologize. For five celebrities and this guy again.
He's a little bitter, folks.
I am a little bitter.
Mr. SP, slow play. That was good for TV. Yeah.
Her. Pull a queen.
her, I'm a seal. I check.
God, I hate you. I really do.
Oh, good.
Right?
Wow. Father Time has woken up.
5 to me?
Jesus Christ. Give me a break.
Yeah, 5 plus 10 equals 15 there, Borgie.
Oh, you're going to do math for me.
Yeah. I'm going to rearrange.
A couple of really smart guys talking here, Brian. Look at all the education in these
the
guys.
The gloves are off,
grade.
Finally.
I'm going to go 100.
Yeah, grade 8th grade education.
Wow. 100 total.
The gloves are off. Go at it, boys.
Yeah.
Why not?
He's raising to 100.
Hondo.
85 more to you.
American?
Yeah. Let's have some fun.
I don't know. I want to, but I don't know if I can.
How much more do I need?
I think you nailed it.
Brian's like, he's
got
money. Brian comes out of the woods. I might have to fold it up.
I'm nervous.
Phil Bork is going to fold.
It's like fighting Stu Grayson
Max
right now.
Max folds. Kevin, who's never been out of a hand.
I like this guy. Honestly, I love this hand.
Much better than the first 20 you played. Here's what I promise. I'm in the lead out of all three of you, but I could get caught. Yeah. And that happened to this.
And here's what I promised. Last time he told the story, it didn't work out.
I gotta see it. I gotta see something. Oh.
Can you even see the board?
No, that's 20. Hang on.
There they are again.
How much is that? That's, wow. That might be 50, right?
Did they call you Helen Keller on the ice? Or
why am I doing this?
Oh, I feel like Helen Keller right now. I might actually puke.
You look like the Nutty Professor. Just hang him a little lower on
Hercules,
your nose.
Hercules.
I used to talk about the old version with Jerry Lewis.
I don't even know what you're talking about. I can't even see this. Sorry.
Oh my God.
Possible straight up there.
The f- is that?
No, stop swearing, please. Stop swearing. That'd be great.
Check him. Oh boy, what a pull that is. I checked.
Yeah.
I'll go another 100.
That's 100.
Oh my God. Wow.
4, 5, 6, a honey cut, huh?
I guarantee I have the best hand. I promise you I have the best hand.
Show those kings.
You're welcome.
What are those?
Oh, eights. Eight. Oh, I had eights earlier.
Oh, eights are nothing. What are you kidding me? I had ace queen.
Eights are better than ace. Eights are better than ace queen, by the way.
Ace queen when I got 4, 5, 6 come up.
Wait, Kevin, you swear a lot.
I get that language. Things aren't going that well.
First face cards I've had for like four hands and
period. I told you, I was being honest with you guys. I wanted
to see what the turn was.
I wasn't going to catch up to you with face cards.
Oh, no, with the eights. But I wasn't slow playing it again.
Eights, my God.
Sorry, not a bad hand.
Not bad, but there's nothing great about it.
Well, it's $400 worth.
There are eights. I got aces, kings. I can't win anything.
Kevin, you're not on a subway. Stop talking to yourself.
Subway.
I've talked to myself on a subway many times.
Subway in Boston trying to get home. I'm talking about subway.
He goes for walks in the daytime. He's like, I can't believe Pocket H made $100.
There's your ace king.
I know.
There's your ace.
That's what I was waiting for right there.
Yeah, but then I would have had the trips.
Check. You have the eights.
Check. I'm going to check.
Check's good.
Max, you're actually responsible.
Am I? Seriously.
For the crowd of women hanging around watching tonight's production. You're really pretty.
Check. Oh, thank you.
You are.
That's the first nice thing you said to me tonight. I appreciate it.
I don't know how you say it in French, but you're really a pretty guy. I just think you're...
I say that, pretty guy in French.
I'm married.
How do you say pretty guy in French?
What? T'es vraiment beau.
Merci.
Boston accent.
Oh, see, he said you too, but he's lying.
I'll bet. I'll do 25, please.
25
big ones.
Yeah. Thank you.
A big one.
Means a lot.
No, really. I mean,
I actually learned French. I'm English, but I learned French because I moved to Quebec City when I was 17.
You think it really means a lot? Look who it's coming from. It doesn't mean much. You know?
You fluent? What? Yeah.
Sometimes
bad grammar.
Sometimes really when Kevin talks, it sounds like another language, doesn't it?
I have a flush draw.
Okay.
But I'm not going to do it because the pot odds don't make sense. But I'm not.
You have other people in the hand.
Oh, sorry.
Just 25. Yeah.
Do you have to net?
Oh, I'm so
security.
I apologize. Party foul.
Security.
Card down.
It's
a three. Card down. Card down. What was that Q-tip that just went by the dealer?
Card down.
I apologize. Pot odds doesn't make sense.
Do you have to narrate every hand, really? Why don't you just go once upon a time?
Once upon a time, I had this.
It's a story with every hand. No. A flushy?
Benny?
Another great hand. No? Hang on one sec because we have to take another break. We'll be right back here at Rivers Casino here in Pittsburgh. Welcome back to Pittsburgh Penguin Night here on Poker Night in America, celebrity home game here at Rivers Casino in beautiful Pittsburgh. We were going to break. You're about to tell me something, and I really want to hear the story. Go ahead, Brian.
Not a long story. I'm 63, but I got a reading skills of a 65-year-old.
Nice.
That's what you pulled
in story.
That's what you pulled me aside to tell me you wanted to
tell you anything.
That was riveting.
Riveting. Riveting.
Really, reading really level. Riveting. I love that.
Riveting, exactly.
I got a great hand here.
Do you? What's wrong with five? What's wrong with just throwing five in?
I'll go 20.
You guys are unbelievable.
I think you're playing.
What's wrong with just throwing five in here and there?
We're throwing 20 in?
He's on a second buy-in. Now he's like, can we just be friendly?
I know. Yeah, can we just call this game? It's not over.
Do you want the raise or I can still?
You can.
No, okay. I'm just going to check.
Jesus. Raise. So he has a raise. What do you think you got over there?
He's raise.
He wants a raise. You have two cards. Yeah.
Well, if you have two really good cards, that's when you raise.
Let's see how blind he really
dad,
is.
But I'm not
Kev, did that help you hand it all?
You don't have to raise. It's three outs in the I got to put money in, though.
You've done that all night.
I'm running a little low right now. Watch this flip. I'm going to throw it.
Watch this. Check.
Ooh, I'm liking this.
A little quiet now.
Everybody's
what happened?
Checking. Like, everybody's you know, checking. What's wrong? Like, I get out and everybody checks.
Can I raise or do I check?
Oh, 60.
Is that your French accent?
That was a horrible 60. French accent.
That was awful.
Yes, and as my brother Bilo, he breaking the cage.
That was awesome.
That suit is black.
Not. That suit is black. Not.
Oh, wow. Call, eh?
I don't know why you went 60. You should have went 50.
60.
It's a $50 raise.
Now, come on, Forky, stick
now
a 60.
I know what you have.
I like it. He's coming.
No clue what I have.
If both of you are calling, one of you has
no,
a 6.
No, he's going to hold.
Okay, Borky, your ring's had enough TV time. Make a decision.
Never enough TV time.
Borky loves the TV time.
Ah. Do you know, you guys didn't believe it.
One thing you don't shy away from, huh?
You guys didn't believe it when I told you that Phil is actually a distant cousin to Raymond Bork.
I believed it, but I didn't know it, and they kind of went through the pipeline. That's like saying you're a distant cousin to who?
Phil Esposito.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got
Phil,
the jersey
on. No, you're Tony's, bro. You're the guy at the bar.
This is the best story ever.
Vinny Barbarino.
The guy at the bar.
You weren't here. We're at the bar. Uh-huh. This is a true story, right? You guys were there.
Yeah, I was there.
We're at the bar. Hey.
All right, but
the bartender comes over to me and goes, listen, it was like 30 years ago. It was either you or your brother, and I was playing college hockey at Dartmouth, New Hampshire.
Check.
And he says, it was either you or your brother. I was a goalie. You came on the ice and gave me advice. And I go, it wasn't me. What are you talking about? He goes, your last name's Esposito. I go, no, it's Favorito, actually. This is just a jersey. People wear them. And he was all embarrassed. I was like, you thought I was Phil Esposito?
That's great.
I'd be on a walker.
I have the best hand.
You always do.
Then bet it.
Till the river.
Yeah.
Flapping your lips.
I have the best hand.
Then bet it.
Yeah, unload it.
Yeah.
Yeah, push something in.
Your coach.
Can you shut your mouth when you're talking to me?
Just push something in.
I have the best hand.
Yeah?
But Trotz doesn't lie.
Well, Trotz is very honest.
I'm extremely honest.
Extremely honest.
You are.
I only know one way.
Like me or you.
I've got no poker face.
But I still think I have the best hand. I think you have eights and sixes.
That's a good call.
I think you have eights and sixes.
That's a boat.
And I have better than that.
Better than a boat.
Vinny, come on, push it. You're the host.
I'm going to let them work this out.
Vinny,
this is
a call.
Then you have aces.
What do you have?
I'm waiting for Trotz.
I have better than eights and sixes.
I'm waiting for Trotz to say, take the pebble from my hand, Grasshopper. I think you're about to get schooled. I really do.
Do you?
I do.
Nah, it's worth 50. I'll bet 50.
That's a good call. I'll go 50 with you.
He's calling you.
You have eights and sixes? Or you have the six? You have the six, huh? Damn.
Show your hands.
He's a good talker.
How do you not raise?
I don't. Just straight down the middle.
Another slow play.
I've had this.
I did a slow play. I was betting it the whole time.
Huh? How much pre-flop?
25.
Not enough.
On a $5 bet.
Seven rings.
Five times the big line.
Seven rings.
Five times the big line.
Seven rings.
Normally it's three times the big
line. Straight as a day is long.
I hate
Steve.
Boring.
Kevin Stevens, we're over here. Who are you talking to?
You know what? There's no man I'd rather lose money to than Trotz.
There we go.
You I hate, but I don't mind losing money to him.
Wow.
You I hate.
This is so great.
I hate everybody right now.
Again, I get burned again. Amelia. We're gonna have a little talk later.
Hardy says he hates everyone right now.
A nice little carving there.
I really don't.
Vinny.
Huh?
A nice little.
Yes. Yes, I do. Yes, I do. And if you weren't so cheap, you could accumulate some.
Come on. Ryan, you in?
I have not won one of these rundowns at all. Thanks to. Thanks to.
You, Chase.
She's the, you felt it though. You called it twice. She's the curse.
I just want to see a couple of cards.
She's the real Grim Reaper, not Stu Grimson. It's Amelia.
Wow.
The hell is that?
I don't know, but I got a feeling Barney's got pocket queens and someone has a seven.
The queens are in vain.
That's really.
I didn't swear pocket queens and someone has a seven.
Something bad.
I didn't swear at all.
Sure you did.
You're the one that's the potty mouth.
I'm gonna fold because I don't want to catch the 4-7 and lose.
I tried to limp in, but not me.
Checker bet.
I'll throw in 10 just for the fun.
Brian.
That's 10.
I had no idea how to play. Just reading.
Stop talking to your chips.
No, I'm talking to myself only. Brian's
Kevin Stevens is talking to
Brian had no idea how to play.
This is my impression of Kevin Stevens. You won't be here much longer. I'm doing my best to keep you around. This is horrible.
We'll go 15.
That's 15.
Oh, boy. Borky, why the long face? Because you have a long face. You have a really long face.
You have a fat face.
Wow. I like it. I like it.
That was hostile.
That was harsh.
For you kids watching at home.
Grace.
I like it, Borky. I like it, kid.
50 total.
I like the game.
50 total?
I like it, Brian.
He's not afraid. He just creeps along.
Talks a lot. It's the way it should be.
What else I need?
One more tip this grill. Maybe she'll come back once in a while, Barney.
No, just one chip.
One more chip.
Why don't you tip the waitress? Yes. She might come back. You guys are, usually when you tip a girl, they come back. When you don't tip them, they stay out there. I don't know if you guys know that.
Yeah, but you have to tip out of your pocket. They need these for the chip.
Thank you so much. Can I tip you?
Yeah, tip it here. Give us some of these.
No, those you have to keep on the table.
That's 15.
No, I'm only kidding, Barney. That's only. Give her a dollar, she'll be back.
Because you handed me the cup in 91. And
that's right, I remember. That was awesome.
Thank you so much.
And to call your first to show.
Nice show, buddy.
He's got a seven again.
Seven?
Oh, jeez.
Wow. You are the king of flops.
There's the trip sevens.
You won.
Brian, you like it, kid.
Thank you.
Folks, listen, we're going to take another break. We will be right back here at Poker Night in America Celebrity Home Game right here in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
Any way to borrow a bunch of chips and pay them back tomorrow?
How would you like to play against the pros on national TV? Download now to play and win. It's absolutely free to play.
I don't follow directions very well. I'm the Bork with two rings. Go ahead. Next question. I knew if I was going to make it in the NHL that I was going to have to drop the gloves. I was going to have to scrap it. I was going to have to get my nose dirty, which I was willing to do. I wasn't a great fighter. I probably won 2, lost 20, but I didn't care. I showed up. And I think that's what got you respect in the NHL. I have not played with any of these guys before. I know Max Talbot and Matthew Barnaby have played a little bit on bigger stages, but this will be the biggest stage I ever played on. I think I got a good poker face. I think a lot of these guys probably play poker the way that they played the game of hockey, that they can be sneaky, that they can act like they're your friend. But they're probably as ruthless as poker players as they were as players. What do you say we take this down to the river and party all summer?
Wow. So why the outburst?
I partied with you that night.
Welcome back to Poker Night in America. Celebrity Home Game, Pittsburgh Penguin Night here at the Rivers Casino in beautiful Pittsburgh.
Wow. 2 for 20 was dead on.
That was great. Oh, they're blind? All right, I'll make it 15.
Raised to
15. Oh, God.
Oh, pocket aces. Oh, so tough to play.
Big, tough guy.
They loved playing with you, though, Borky. A lot of fun. I got to know you this week. You're a super guy. Super guy.
Love the game, man.
You love the game, but you're just a fun guy all around. I mean, always laughing. But you're a Boston guy. You got it in your blood.
Yeah. Work hard, play hard.
That's it. That's it.
Solid Boston.
Nothing wrong with that.
One of the best media in the league, too, for being the player, like Borky, for the whole time it was a when you were there,
yeah.
Yeah, for 6 years he was.
Who's this, me?
You.
One of the best, if not the best.
Adi.
Thanks, Adi.
I'm gonna go a little bit. I'm just gonna go 50.
How's that? Did I leave you hanging?
God, we want you to win a pot so bad.
I have a breaker.
I'm actually gonna fold
and I have a good hand. Because I want you to win. I want you to win $12.
Thanks, buddy. All right, I'm just gonna call him.
I'm gonna call this.
You gotta wait for him. Now you can call.
No, definitely.
Now? I'm gonna call now.
A little premature.
Yeah, sorry.
Maxime?
I'm a 2-9er fan. You can play forward, defense, goalie.
Looks like 50.
Goalie was scary.
I can play goalie. I wasn't afraid to play goalie. I wasn't afraid to put the pads on.
Kick saving the beauty. That was dynamite. Over at the old freezer there.
60. I loved it.
I didn't make it. He made it.
78.50 Canadian.
Utility man, but beyond that, like just.
Just be careful. Don't go through all your
team player.
Just be careful. That's all I'm going to tell you.
What a mess.
Stop swearing. Check a bet. No. Can't do that. Check a bet.
Tell them what the cards are.
Just
3, 9, 6, 7, 2
Check a bet. Just check, please.
Check.
It's taking you down.
He doesn't want it.
Concentration is really good.
Let's go 50.
Oh, no. He can't do that. He can only bet 25.
Oh,
yeah, okay, welcome to our country.
Thank you. First time ever.
Yeah, you gotta call.
Yeah, of course.
All right, I can't say that.
I got no choice.
This is crazy. I call too. All right. Two pair wins. I have pocket kings.
Wow. All right,
let's
watch this.
Two.
I got 9 7s, two pairs.
What you got?
Two pairs.
He finished third.
Hey, listen, we're going to check out some of Phil Bork's highlights. I've been waiting to see this.
Me too.
Bring it.
Me too.
Left winger Phil Bork.
What do you say we take this out on the river and party all summer?
In the Cicerelli minor, Jágr, the smooth skating young Czechoslovakian player for the Penguins, finds Stevens, cross ice Lemieux all by himself. Bork with a drive, scores! A power play goal, we're tied.
That was exciting. That was great. When you had that hairstyle, you looked like you were going so fast all the time.
Hey, chicks dug the mullet.
Wow. Great helmet, by the way.
Thanks.
Yeah. What made you play with that helmet?
It made the flow look good.
Yeah.
It was light. I didn't feel like I was wearing a helmet.
Yeah.
The crazy thing about that helmet, there was a sticker inside that helmet that said, "This helmet is not to be used in the game of ice hockey."
Really?
Yeah. It was a broom ball helmet in Sweden, the Jofa. I mean, Gretzky, I thought it was cool. I thought it was, no pad at all.
Yeah.
The hockey news on your helmet was probably more protection. I shouldn't have used it.
I think that helmet with his hair made him look like a little McSorley, didn't it? A little bit in the footage? Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely. With better hands and
speed. Lots of speed.
Better feet.
Best story from Gretzky ever, by the way, on McSorley. McSorley comes in after a playoff game and he's like, they're on the power play. And McSorley's like, Gretz. Check. I'm open. You gotta see me back door. I'm open.
Five players.
Gretz is sipping his Coke. He doesn't even look up. And he goes, I have over 2,000 assists. I see you. I'm just choosing not to pass to you. The whole team just bursts out laughing. He's like, oh, okay. Okay. Good.
Okay, we're good.
But I see you.
But you do see me.
You see me. Check.
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 Check's good.
I'll check.
I'll check.
My favorite line from Mario too, when he came back. He came back from Hodgkin's disease and obviously the bad back, and he came back. And I'm gonna check.
we terrible 6. First period, and he looks at our D and he's like, "Hey, D to D to them isn't working. Let's try something new."
Yeah, he didn't like giving the puck up to the other team.
I know you had the best hand, blah blah blah.
No, I don't have a good.
I had a 6.
I had a flush draw.
I had a 6.
Doesn't matter. Whatever you have.
Well, okay. we have to pay a lot of bills here, and we're gonna take another break. We will be back here at the Rivers Casino here in Pittsburgh.
I started playing poker when I was 20 years old, I'd say, in Wilkes-Barre, Scranton. My first pro year in hockey, and I started. There was a restaurant we used to go all the time and play cash games till kind of late at night. And that year we played cards quite a bit. I went to the World Series of Poker in 2007. I was doing pretty well to start the tournament on the first day. And then the later it got during the day, well, I figured out I'll order a drink. And then after that, it went downhill from there. I never played with any of the guys that'll be at the table right now. So I'm trying to catch on as fast as I can. I would like to say I like to play. I'm not a very patient player. I like to play different hands that sometimes wouldn't be the smartest to play, but I will not fold often.
Welcome back to Pittsburgh Penguin Night right here on Poker Night in America, celebrity home game here at the Rivers Casino in Pittsburgh. We're playing 5-5 Texas Hold'em, and we just saw, Max, your interview, a little bit of your interview. And you were in the World Series of Poker, and how far did you get? Was it just day one? Is that what you were saying?
Day one.
And you said you were doing pretty good. Is that because you found the table you were seated at, or I don't get it.
Exactly.
If you were down in day one, how were you doing well?
Well, at the start of the day, I was surprised I was doing that well because I won a small tournament with, you know, NHL and everything. We're 9 hockey players, and it pays for the entry fee and everything. So I was, like, happy to be there. It was just the longer I got there, it was just –
Oh, that's how you got to the World Series. Nine of you put up 1,000 each, and
no, it was a TSN type of thing.
Canadian Sports Network.
Yes, exactly. What do I have? I can't talk and play at the same time. Yeah, I'll 20, please.
Yeah, patience is tough.
So I won a competition to get there. So it was kind of for me. I knew it was not gonna last. These guys are so good. I'm not patient enough. I like to play, and once I start, I have a vodka Red Bull at one point. I'm like,
I think you lasted longer than Kevin would have lasted because patience is not on your side.
I left the hand with two guys. I had a 50, I could have won 50 grand. I just decided to leave. Leave the guy the money. How'd that sound? Pretty good.
What happened?
I was playing this hockey thing. I think it came down to three of us. It was, I don't know, $30,000. It's like there for 6 hours. I said, I gotta go. Just went, I'm going to the bathroom. Never came back. Oh, it's torture.
Now, you and Trotz actually have a funny story together, right? Involving, what was it?
Bellows?
Bellows.
Trotz, that was
Kevin
that,
started the whole thing.
Tell the story without swearing.
No. Bellows started the whole thing.
Yeah, he started the whole thing, but you called him on it, which was really
I called him on it. You know, it was kind of one of those things where, you know, they show me in Trotsky, they don't show him laying on the ice like someone shot him in the stands. You know,
so he's trying to drop
him. He's laying on the ice, drawing a penalty. Everybody blows the whistle. Everybody comes out. He's okay. You know, goes to the bench. 5 seconds later, arm goes up. We get a penalty. Who's the first guy over the Minnesota bench? Bellows. Like, you know, like nothing ever happened. And then the faceoff was near our bench, so it was kind of.
You're still slow playing this?
It worked on him a little bit.
It worked on him. It's on YouTube. You guys were ruthless to this guy.
That was a good one.
And you, this quiet, meek guy, so nice.
That was bad. You
battle, yeah. A lot of that's computer generated. Yeah. If you read my lips, I'm saying, hey, Brian, I'll see you in the summer. A beer together. Yeah. But I don't know who dubbed my voice.
We really didn't mean anything, Brian. It was one of that's how hockey was back then. It was just free. There was never cameras. I mean, no mics. No, there was no mics back then. We can say anything we want. Now you say that around, then you get about 30 games.
Yeah. Say any of that stuff.
And we didn't really mean much of it, but
I've done 100 events with Brian, and it's cool.
It was just one game.
Big deal.
We got some poker.
We got some action now.
Action!
$200 to you, Mr. Barnaby.
He definitely has me.
It's for the TV. I'm just putting on a show.
He definitely had me.
Diamonds galore.
I think he's got more than diamonds.
You don't think so?
Yeah.
No way.
I think he has a pocket there.
No.
Will you show me?
Sure.
I'm beat. I tried to. Show me.
Diamonds, right?
Okay, that was Max Talbot's poker highlight. Now let's see some of your hockey highlights.
Orpik will rush to center, likely dump the puck in to finish the change. Max Talbot, there he is again, forechecking right in on Brad Stewart, who stayed with the puck, turned it over, score! Max Talbot gets the game's first goal. Pittsburgh leads 1-0. And here up the boards for Kunitz, and he'll battle Brad Stewart and gets the puck out. Here's a 2-on-1. Talbot with Kennedy. Talbot shoots. He scores!
Yeah! Yeah! That was awesome, brother. Awesome. But you're also, you did the coolest thing. You got in a fight with a guy you had no business fighting. and that's when you're known for the shh.
Yeah.
Tell that story a little
bit. Well, that happened quite a bit when I got in the fights with a guy I had no business with. Probably like Matthew a little bit. But yeah.
Who was the Philly player, though?
It was Carcillo.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
He killed you.
He did. But
he killed me.
I could have fought better than you.
When you do something like that, we were down 3-0, and then you know, I was responsible for the first goal again. So when you do something like that, it's not necessarily going to go the way you want. I don't care about winning the fight or losing, but 25. The teammate's got to respond. You know, if you do this and you lose the game, the momentum doesn't change. It's not going to change anything.
You went on to win the game.
You don't understand the game, Vinny, you know?
Yeah, so they scored 3 goals.
Kind of like you and Holden.
One more time.
Yeah, so they ended up scoring 3 goals in 4 minutes, I think. So it's just... I got pretty lucky, and
it's good. It's all good.
But you're also a bit of a prankster too. You did something that
Amelia River me. Here it comes.
I thought it was kind of cool, but kind of a letdown to the kids. Why don't you explain the Sidney Crosby jersey switch?
Yeah, well, that was on a morning skate, on a optional skate for us, but it was a full house in Toronto. They had a kid student, like they packed up the rink in Toronto, and we were 4 guys skating, so I ended up putting the Sidney Crosby jersey, and I went and did 1 or 2 laps in Toronto, and the kids went, nah, Sidney Crosby's on the ice, and I went back to the locker room, and Don Cherry got pretty mad at me that night, where,
because they knew it wasn't you.
Exactly.
Do you feel good when you hurt kids? Seriously, you're professional hockey player making millions of dollars, and you said, let me hurt the kids today?
That was not the intention. Now that I have kids, no, I probably would not. No, I'd still do it.
Did you already river me?
Brian just don't give in.
She actually already rivered me.
We got some action again here.
Amelia's
this
just
is some crush.
No, she's crushing me. She's killed me every time. Oh. I know she did it again.
She is crushing.
Oh, we got some action.
Well, you went in big time. I was.
No,
I
know.
She
already crushed me, and I know you have the hand. I'll bet another 100.
Jesus.
And he's got
Brian,
it.
Come on.
He was first to act.
Wow. Love it, kid.
Wow. No hesitation. I'll call it. I don't want to go crazy.
This guy's not. We're redding the chips right now.
You have been around the action all night.
Boy, and I've lost on every one of the actions. Well, he doesn't have queens because he wouldn't have called it on that. So he either has a flush or he has a
king. He's checking. You're going to him for advice?
You're looking at the wrong guy. I hate to say it.
How can you go to him for advice?
I just got it the other way when you look at me.
God, you're like my divorce attorney in my first marriage.
Believe me, I've been there too.
I can't help you.
Wow.
I'm looking over there. I have no idea. I'm looking for help.
I don't even know what to tell you.
I actually think I have the best hand.
I think you're
again, but I thought I had the best hand 4 times. I've lost every time.
Why don't you just like say, you know what I'm saying?
No, nobody knows what you're saying.
I don't know. Brian's in for the long haul, I think.
There's no way you're paying 100 for every flush draw, I don't think. So I think you have a king.
Oh, man.
Then you have me beat. There's no way you're pulling on a queen.
Queen has nothing to do with it.
Thanks, Tip. It's one time at band camp.
Yeah. I forgot there's 2 queens.
I'll bet 100.
That's 100.
I gotta go.
God.
just wouldn't listen.
I lost again.
I don't know.
So,
I don't know.
I think I got a king.
You got a king?
Yeah.
I got a king.
Kings and queens with a 10.
Oh, you win.
Kings and queens.
Thank God. Patrickson has put his chips up, and we're going to take a break. We'll be back right here. Poker Night America, Celebrity Home Game. We're so happy for you.
Hey, Frank the Tank. Frank the Tank.
You're kings and queens. What's that?
Are you still mad at Amelia now?
Welcome back to Pittsburgh Penguin Night right here on Poker Night in America, Celebrity Home Game here at Rivers Casino. Let's get back to the poker action. Wow, you took down a big one that time.
Good job, Matt.
Thank you. She finally rivered me in a really, really, really good way. It's been a struggle.
I will fold.
I'm in.
Playing a lot of hands, Brian, for a guy who didn't have any...
I have no clue what I'm doing, but I'm in.
Like, well, you've been holding up pretty good, and you had to stay in that hand.
Oh, yeah.
You had to. You had no choice. Tough
Matt
break.
Matt deserved that one.
Re-raise. Oh,
boy. I'm up.
Not yet.
I'm in.
Oh,
50.
50 total.
Okay, now you can fold.
I'm out.
Okay, he's not coming back at you. That's a good sign.
No.
Because everybody knows when you're in, you always have
Artie
the best
Express.
Hand.
Express.
I'm in.
Try, right?
Who has the best hand more than you?
Artie.
Nobody.
No. Artie deserves one.
I'm going against Stanley Cup champions right now. I feel like
overmatched. Right here, here's your turn.
I'll check that. Someone's aggressive.
That was with conviction.
That was very aggressive.
That's conviction.
That scared me. That.
I'll see you, Arnie.
Mario whacked me.
Yeah, you got to
just get out.
Just get out.
Let's go. I'm guessing you got King Jack.
Wake up. Let's go.
I don't know what I got.
Kevin, keep your head up. You look so bummed out. You got a winner this time.
What was the bet?
That is
40.
40.
Just the way you dropped
it. He said,
I know.
Very angry.
Nothing I can really do about it. You know, Brian, it's out of my control.
Yeah,
I can just play the game.
Hockey gods are smiling on you right
Thanks,
now.
Thanks, buddy.
It's cool.
I think I'm in second place right now.
Here we go.
Talbot's gonna jump in. Why can't he get out?
I think Talbot's is in third. I think you're first.
The Macbeth of poker.
Jack?
Yeah. Everything's a story. Let me sweat one. Wow.
I'll check.
Yeah.
I'll check.
All right.
Okay.
I'll check. We're all friends.
There you go. Here comes the killer card. I knew that was coming.
Look at those spades.
Wow. A lot of spades, but still a shot at a full house up there, too.
That's cool.
If someone was.
Whose bet is it?
Two pre-flop.
Calvo.
I'd be very surprised.
Check that.
Check.
I'm just gonna put 50 in.
That is 50.
I think you have ace king. I do think you have ace king, and I think you have the spade, but I'm gonna pay you off. You know why? Because I love you.
If you're ever on any boardwalk and you need your fortune read, I think this is the guy to see.
Brian, you win or
I'll call. I call, buddy. I got a good hand.
I don't have a great hand.
No, one more player.
I got a good hand.
Yeah,
he's got the bullet.
I think I had the second best hand.
No, fold it up.
I'm folding.
You are good. I gotta say, he might be a snake.
You got ace king, right?
Yeah. What do you got? Spades?
You're first to show.
You're first to show.
Oh.
Carrot.
Kings
I will
Jesus.
Read your hands. You're a very nice guy.
You don't want to flip this over. It's a queen of spades.
Queen of spades.
Oh, you know what? I thought there was only three spades up there.
Yeah.
I swear to God.
No.
So those good. Glasses.
I swear to God. I thought there was a club.
I thought you were gonna bet.
When the game's over, if you need help crossing the street, I'm here for you, Kevin.
I thought it's 8:03.
This is crazy. You know what I love? I was through the whole thing. You have a great haircut. I really do. I just got mine all cut out, but I'm gonna get it all done. But you have a really great haircut. I go to a place. Actually, my buddy Crazy Jake at the Chop Shop. That's what it's called. You can get a new car and a haircut while you're there. The Chop Shop.
A new car and a haircut. My brother cuts his own hair, so I understand.
Crazy Jake. Where do you go to the Chop Shop? What do you need? A muffler? No, I need a haircut. Oh.
Who is the call here?
You probably don't want to ask any more questions. Whatever gets to you, you lose chips.
I'm out.
Let's just hope it stalls right around here.
All right, you up?
20.
Jeez.
Where do we put the other piles?
Wow.
He wins two hands and he's all cocky about it.
You're the big hand, though.
Do we start mountains or?
Oh.
You raise that?
Yeah.
Just going to call that.
It's almost over, Kevin.
She went home Friday.
I feel like we should get hit with like a blow dart.
She went home Friday. Nobody stuck around for this.
I'm dying.
Check.
Oh, you're killing me.
Cost me a fortune to stick around here.
That is 50.
Oh,
God.
50?
50.
Fitty?
Oh, fitty. How do you say it in Canada? 50s?
Sega.
Sega. Sega.
Sega. Yeah.
Sega. Sega. Max.
Sega. Oh, yeah. Yes.
Let's do this hand in French.
Okay.
Okay.
On va faire ça en français.
All right.
Okay.
Ooh. Oh. 17.
5. T'as-tu un 6?
No.
5, 6?
No.
Who's in?
J'ai des bonnes cartes.
What's he saying? He watches Seinfeld? Is that what he said?
J'ai un 4.
Un 4. That's my 4. 6.
Monkey 6.
I'll check.
You're playing straight.
Check.
You're playing straight. I don't have a straight. He just asked me if I have a 6. I said I have a 4. I think you're trying to pull something, and I think I have the better hand.
Oh.
I'm going to bet 100.
Again.
That's 100.
Wow.
I think I have the best hand. I really do.
Yeah.
Oh, and I think you're trying to pull us.
I'm just
flush.
Trying to.
He's going
to
pull. Listen, all of us are having fun except for Kevin Stevens. He just wants to stand. Take a break. We'll be back in just a few minutes right here at Poker Night in America Celebrity Home Game.
You know? I've had aces 4 times and lost every single time. Flip aces like you get a huge hand.
So that about does it for Pittsburgh Penguin Night. Let's see how things shook out in the end. Phil Bork still ended up winning the most at 440. Nice comeback for Matthew Barnaby, who was stuck 260, now up 320. Max Talbot up 170. Our host, Vinny Favorito, up 140. Brian Trottier down 200, not bad. And Kevin Stevens never could quite turn it around. He is stuck $870. That'll wrap things up. Vinny, back to you.
Thanks, Jesse, for the chip update. We appreciate that, the chip count, guys. This has been so much fun. I just wish the stuff during the commercials could be played on this game. Max, you know, it was my first time meeting you. You're a great player, but did you have a good time playing poker tonight?
I had a blast. You were just the odd man out. I mean, we had a blast. You were
the best. And Phil, how about you? Did you have a great time?
You can call me Borky.
The old two-niner.
Everything was fun except you, man.
We already called Cher a ride to come get you.
Thank you. Thanks, Phil.
We love you. And, of course, Matthew, you're wonderful.
I love you.
And you are just a razor blade waiting to happen.
You are so good, buddy.
We are Poker Night in America Celebrity Home Game. It's time to wrap it up. We want to thank all the staff behind the show, everyone at Rivers Casino, our beautiful dealer, Amelia.
Right.
We will see you next time right here on Poker Night in America Celebrity.
Hey, quit writing mean stuff in the comments, guys. I'm just kidding. Everything you write helps us. It's called engagement. Go to town. Also, like and subscribe. But you'll write the mean stuff, too. It's all good.